Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. We are finally going to Liara's dig site. Whether she's going to be there, I'm not sure. As you can see, we're just leaving the planet of Zawin. We fought some people. There was a dead guy there. Strenuous system, hidden thingy. Out. Okay, so Horsehead Nebula is done. Local cluster, I think, is Earth? We need to go there for some reason. Robots going crazy or something like that. Liara's dig site, though, we're gonna go here now. Been to Hades Gamma as well. This is Sparta! And we've also got Macedon, Athens, and Knossos. Okay, very Greek-oriented. Artemis Tau system. Where? Which one are we going to? Hold on. Oh, wrong thing. Journal. Explore the uncharted worlds of the Artemis Tau cluster to finally. Oh, okay. We don't know which planet she's on. Okay. I guess I've forgotten. It's been so long since we were given that mission. That we can't just go to the dig site. Where the dig site is. Let's go to Sparta first. Yes, I'm travel to another system. Sparta! Okay. Tree Man Re. Edolus. Ataya. Antamalka. In El Sieges. Start from here and go out. Small, distant El Sieges, I guess, is a small terrestrial with a trace atmosphere of methane and argon. The surface is composed actually of water, ice, and calcium, with occasional deposits of light metals. During the Alliance's pirate suppression campaign in the 2160s, the Batarian Eluam Ranpera was caught with his frigate Teneran grounded on all stages for drive discharge. When challenged by the cruiser Hyderabad, Ranpera refused to surrender. The Teneran was destroyed attempting to take off. The debris is strewn across the southern hemisphere. It is extremely cold. Survey. Rare elements surveyed. Scans from orbit have detected a small deposit of plutonium. Nice. Okay, one planet down. Antamalka is a large hydrogen-helium gas giant with traces of chlorine and sulfur in the atmosphere. Its massive gravity well tugs many asteroids from the outer belt inwards, past the orbit of Altaïa and Edolus, and eventually settle into the inner belt. Antamalka's orbit is congested with hundreds of captured moons. Most last only a few thousand years before being ejected, dragged down into the atmosphere, or ripped apart by tidal forces and added to the gas giant's immense rings. Attempting to navigate this chaotic environment is hazardous at best. Ships without military-grade kinetic barriers are likely to suffer catastrophic impacts. Gas deposit. Surveyed. Scans from orbit have detected a large concentration of hydrogen. Okay, yeah, we don't land on those gas giants. That's, well, technically there's really nothing to land on. Altaïa. Can't even survey this one. Altaïa is an unusually large terrestrial world with a trace atmosphere of methane and ammonia. The surface is frozen and mainly composed of sandstone and other sedimentary rocks with deposits of iron and chlorides. Judging by the sedimentary composition of the crust, it appears that Altaïa once possessed an atmosphere thick enough to support some form of liquid. What cataclysm stripped the atmosphere and left the planet to freeze is not currently known. Wonder if we'll ever find that out. If so, guys, no spoilers, do not tell me. Edolus.
Second planet. I'm picking up a signal from the planet's surface. It looks like an automated distress beacon.
Hello? Oh, we're gonna land on this one. I'll check out the other planet first, though. Edolus is a terrestrial planet with an atmosphere of carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Edolus's surface is covered by wide deserts of silicate sand, with only a few areas of igneous rock highlands to break the abrasive, dust-choked wind. Edolus's orbit is congested with debris thrown inwards by the gravity of the gas giant Antalmaca. Due to a high rate of meteor impacts, exploration is highly dangerous. Great. I just want to take a look at Trimanri, so I know we're done with the system when we're done with that planet. Trimanri is a dwarf planet composed of light magnesium silicates with deposits of aluminum. Its surface is covered by wide swaths of ancient dark basaltic lava, possibly indicating the world was created through an impact with some other body in the system. Trimanri's magnetic field is non-existent. This makes it impossible for ships to dump drive charge from orbit. That said, Trimanri's minuscule gravity allows even cruiser-sized vessels to land safely for direct grounding. Well, we're not going to be doing that. Landing on Edolus. I'm going to take Rex and Tally again. Have no idea if Liara is here, or is this someone else in distress? Maybe both. Oh, brother. Are we gonna randomly die? I mean, how can we avoid that stuff? Debris. Distress signal. An anomaly. I say go right for the distress signal right now. You know what? We probably should, but I'm gonna go boop, boop, boop. Oh, brother. They go around us a little bit. What? Ooh. What are you hoping to excavate here, Liara, if that's you? Hitting the wrong key here. Whee! I mean, I guess we'll be okay. They drop us from flying past. It looks like miles up in the air. But still, I don't want to drive off a cliff if I can help it. Lithium deposit, okay. Can I... I gotta do this just to survey a mineral, too. Deposit of lithium, okay. Alright, let's head into our maid in distress here. distressing. Oh, there's debris here too? Alright, let's go to this then. Debris. Can I head the right way? No. This way. Gotta turn. And I don't know. Can I even get up? Ooh. Yeah, there's craters and stuff all over the place here. No, we're missing our duties just by looking for this instead of the distress signal. But it's sort of on our way. Aha! There we go. Oh, brother. No can do. Ooh. Ooh, I almost did it? Ah. I almost got there. You guys are wondering why I reduced things to Omnigel? This is why. We need it just to get in here. High explosive 4 shredder rounds for this different. Ablative coating. Alright, let's go back in here and check it out. I'm afraid something could randomly just fall on us. Shredder rounds. Plus 25% damage versus organics. Designed to shear apart an impact for maximum damage, these rounds are particularly effective against living targets. Hmm. What do I have now? Polonium rounds? Hmm. See if they have anything. Shredder rounds are new. I don't remember seeing that. And we're not using it. I just hold on to it for now. No new hammerhead. I'm still waiting for hammerhead rounds 3. Sheesh. We're up to 4 with everything else. Alright, let's go. Distress signal here. Coming! Here we come! Wee! Wee, damn it, wee! Oh my! Aye, aye, aye. Pretty hard to traverse here. Up here. Up, up. Alright. Alright, looks like we got a little valley going on down here, and I can see it there in the distance. whatever that is. A ship or a building. That's where the distress signal is coming from, and it's that thing. Oh, you gotta be freaking kidding me. It's coming out randomly. Well, I couldn't move there. Damn it. We died? Damn it, guys. Well, I'll be back. Okay. Here we go again. Just want to share this with you guys. Look, the sun. Or, well, the sun of this world. And wow. Is shining through here, and I'm... Okay. I went and got the stuff that I did before. Same stuff, the lithium deposit. There we are with that over there, and... I'm gonna quick save. I found some... When I looked at the probe, there were some different, ammo upgrades, like a rail extension 4, which helps with overheating and stuff, so that's pretty... At least that one is random. I don't know about this frickin' thing. It appears all over the damn place. I'm just gonna save a little closer, because I might die again. Very likely. There's an Alliance Marine there. Is he dead? Oh my, he's close, huh? What? What'd you say, Tally? Is that you, Tally? Where is it? Did I kill it? Can't be that easy. It's coming back again, isn't it? Seriously? Yeah, it's back. I was not believing the hype on that one. How do I know when it's really dead? Because when it dies, it just goes back into the sand anyway. Oh, it just disappeared, didn't it? Oh! It looked dead now. Unless there's more than one of them. I really don't want to get out of this thing just in case. But we have to, don't we? They're dead, Jim. Quick saving before I get out of this thing and get killed.
Alliance soldiers. Looks like they were lured here by the distress beacon.
Oh, as were we.
Looks like these men were under Admiral Kahoku's command. You want to know what happened here?
They don't have anything else to say. Okay. So I guess she's not here. Can I do anything with this? would love to shut it off somehow. Well, that doesn't make sense, does it? So we're just gonna leave it there transmitting. So more soldiers can go to their doom. I mean, we're gonna inform... whoever. The council. EarthGov. Oh, sorry. Going back to Babylon 5 now. EarthGov. Alright, let's head for this anomaly then. I figured she might be here. Search continues. Kinda doubtful she's on this world, but let's just finish it up. Glad I actually did destroy that thing. I just needed to move a little bit more, I believe. That sounded very close. How steep are we talking here? Whoa! It's a bumpy ride! Hold up, hold up. Where are we? Where is it? Over here? In here? Where? Basically, right on top of it. Well, from up here, we might be able to see it. That's us, right? Okay. So we need to... I'd like to move without... Yeah, turn without moving. Okay, never mind. Whoops! Okay. Yeah, that's okay. We got dropped out of spaceships all the time. And I lose my voice. Is it up on top of the peak there? Where? Oh! Tiny little thing, mummified Salarian. Really? Recover artifact. Relieve you of your artifact. ID tag recover. You found Captain Milan's identification tag. How it ended up here is impossible to know for sure. Alright. Let's get the hell out of this place. Okay. 1 out of 4 systems complete. Done with the Sparta system. Let's go to Knossos next. Subwarp speed travel. Knossos system. Here is Arcanes. A small hydrogen-helium gas giant, Arcanes has been developed as a full-featured if modest, stopover for ships hauling refined materials from Therum. In addition to a powerful magnetic field to dump drive charge, Arcanes has a largely automated infrastructure of helium-3 refining and deuterium mining on its many water ice moons. Survey. Gas deposit surveyed. Large concentration of nitrogen. What's the next one in orbit here? Armeni. Huh, like Armenian. Armenia. Armeni is a terrestrial world with an unusually thin atmosphere of krypton and xenon. Its surface is composed of silica with deposits of carbonaceous materials. That's a new word for me. I think I pronounced it correctly, though. The initial flyby probe of Armeni detected multiple areas at the equator with oddly regular surface protrusions. Closer investigation revealed these as millions of elaborate crypts a few meters below the surface, left by a long-extinct spacefaring species called the Zeoff. Many human universities wish to perform archaeological excavations. Council law holds grave sites as sacrosanct, however, and the matter has been tied up in court for a decade. Huh. I can definitely see a good argument from both sides on that. Zakros. Which is... what do we have here? We have four planets. Zakros is the second from the sun. Zakros is a terrestrial world with a nitrogen-methane atmosphere containing trace amounts of hydrocarbons. Its frigid surface is mainly composed of water ice and hydrocarbon slush. Most of the surface is not solid enough to support the full weight of a landed ship. If approach is necessary, use shuttles or keep the ship's mass effect envelope up. How about we not land there at all? Oh no! We have five planets, sorry, I didn't see this one. Okay, second is Therum. I guess we can land there, that seems like mentioning that, yeah. Therum is a distant but rich industrial world claimed by the Human Systems Alliance. Its plentiful heavy metals have fueled a recent manufacturing boom on Earth. Core samples rich with the fossils of simple silicon-based organisms indicate Therum was more habitable in the past than it is as present. Perhaps this explains the many Prothean ruins dotting the surface, most of which have been looted by mining corporations. Okay, colony was founded in 2167, population of 34,000, capital is Nova Yekaterinburg. Okay, before we go here though, we're gonna check out this one planet here. Phaistos. I do this because I'll probably forget after I leave Therum. And whatever other planet we land on. Phaistos is a small terrestrial with a trace atmosphere of carbon dioxide and xenon. The surface is scorching hot and mainly composed of sulfur and various silicates. There is little of interest on this desolate world. However, there is much of interest here. Okay, we're not docking here.
Commander, I'm picking up some strange readings. Really strange, like off the damn charts. It looks like it's coming from an underground complex a few clicks away from the drop zone.
Huh. Interesting. Oh, wow. Refinery. Oh, look at that. Tunnel exit. I can't even move up that far. S- So we're in the middle of this tunnel. Can we get out? Is it safe to get out here? Guess so. These, I'm guessing, we can't get into. So, readings of what, exactly? Oops. My head! I got a splitting headache. Anyone got some ibuprofen? One tunnel on this side, let's go over there. Just in case there's anything to see, and we got some stuff up there. Oh wow, kinda really shaky here. And that's not frame rate hit, that's just the environment shaking around here. Or us. Alright. Seems a little smoother when I run like this, though. Long way around. Okay. Oh my. What's this? What is this? Can I... Is that liquid? Is that molten lava? It is, right? Because we're dying. Okay, now we know what it is. Imagine how quickly we could have advanced in science if we have a reload feature when something fails. We'd probably be as advanced as Mass Effect humans. Whoa, 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 no. No can go. Oh, cool, look at that sunset though. And all the steam, I guess? Steam or smoke? I'm guessing steam. From the molten lava river. Can't go that way. This way? Came from along there, right? Gotta make sure I don't plummet into lava. Oh, loading. Interesting, I would kind of, who's this? Hello?